While going on long rides with your family on highways, you must have seen fields on the sides of the roads. Or while visiting a village, you must have seen fields in which crops are grown. So the question arises is that why do we need such a huge amount of plants to be grown? The answer to that question would be that since the population is so much in our country or in the whole world, the amount of food that is required is also very high. So there needs to be a systematic arrangement for production of a large quantity of food. So that is the need of large-scale food production. The need of large-scale food production is because we need to feed all the population in a country. Also, the management and distribution of food is also important since if we are obtaining or we are producing a resource, proper transport of that or supply of that resource, that is the crops or the food, is necessary so that it reaches all of the population for which it is being produced. Now let's first see what is the definition of crop. Crop is the production of a large number of plants of the same type at a place. They are cultivated and maintained by men, such as croplands and fields, which we just talked about. Or vineyards, for example, of fruits and grapes, we have heard of them. So these in which a same type of crop or a fruit or a vegetable is grown, that would be a cropland, and the whole number of plants collectively would be called as the crop. So now talking about the crop types, we must be familiar with all of these cereals. We all of us use all of these in our daily life, in our daily food. So first would be cereals, that is wheat, rice, maize, pulses. We use the dals, that is lentils, chickpeas, kidney beans, that is rajma, etc. Third is the vegetables, cauliflower, pumpkins, brinjal, you name it. And fourth is the fruits, apples, grapes, or dry fruits, which are being produced later on after the drying of fruits. These are all types of crops which need to be grown on a large scale in a cropland. Now, we see that the same type of crops are not produced everywhere. What could be the reason for that? The reason for that would be if we talk about only our country, India, we see that the climate is different everywhere. The soil type you must have seen, somewhere it's black, somewhere it's sandy, or the humidity, somewhere it's humid or hot most of the time of the year, somewhere it's cold. So we can't expect a similar type of crop to grow in each of those conditions. So the factors affecting the variety of crops would be temperature first, second would be humidity, third would be rainfall, and fourth would be the soil type. Moving on, the major cropping patterns of India. Cropping patterns of India would depend on the conditions which we talked just before, that is the soil, temperature, water, etc. First, these patterns are classified according to the season in which the plant is sown and harvested. First, let's learn about the season cycle in India mostly, majorly, because monsoon is mainly related to India. So the cycle is that summer, then monsoon, then autumn, early winter and winter, and then spring, and then summer again. This is the season cycle. Now, these three depend on this season cycle for the sowing of plants as well as their harvesting. First one is the kharif crops. These are also called as monsoon crops because these are sown at the beginning of the monsoon. That's why let's talk about first what is sowing. Sowing means planting the seed by scattering in fields, and harvesting is the gathering a ripe crop from fields. So this is the initial thing to do, and this is the final thing to do. And when this starts and this ends, that whole constitutes the cropping season, which will determine the cropping pattern. So sown at monsoon beginning, and it will be harvested at autumn. So these are the monsoon crops. Example would be paddy, rice, maize, soybean, groundnut, bajra, ragi and cotton. Second is the rabi crops. These are grown in winter, sown in autumn. So when these ones are harvested, these ones are sown. And this its month would be June to September because we know monsoon comes at this time. So coming back to rabi, grown in winter and sown in autumn. Sown in autumn, grown in winter from October to March. Around this time they will be harvested. So from here to here it would be kharif, and from here to here it would be rabi. Third would example of rabi is wheat, gram, pea, mustard, linseed, barley, green peas. And these crops get the water themselves because monsoon is there, but these ones need irrigation because in winters, water is not there naturally. Third is the zaid crops. These are short season crops because their time limit is just this much, the summer. So from March to July, they are grown, and they are also grown on irrigated lands because natural water is not there. Example would be pumpkin, cucumber, and bitter gourd. So that was all about the cropping patterns. There's a small assignment for all of you which you have to do in your notebook. Make a comparative table of the three cropping patterns of India. Their examples, their seasons, their sowing and harvesting time, and their names. Keep washing your hands and stay safe.